today we're going to walk through a quick demonstration of how we can utilize the SCA platform for NetSuite to build an in-store selling application that gives us the ability to sit down, work with a customer, select an item, customize that item, and ultimately see what the effect is on the price for that item is that we customized. So as you can see, we are currently looking at a demonstration site with our user, Jack. This again would represent an in-store selling application that we would use to sit down with Jack to customize, in this case, a pool table. So as you can see from this particular demonstration page, this is basically just a standard e-commerce website page that was created using the SCA platform. This platform gives you the ability to do anything that you would need to do in terms of coming up with either an in-store selling application website or external facing e-commerce website. Gives you the ability to brand it, customize it, add text, images, whatever you'd want to do from a website perspective to make it look and feel the way that you want it to. So what we're going to do is we are going to start the process, and we are going to click on this link right here that says select and build. This is going to take us to our shopping area within our website. You can see that when we clicked on that, it brought up several images that we have of items available for us to select from and ultimately use to customize a final product. In this particular case, because it's a demo, we only have a few items loaded here, but you'll get a sense of what we can do with these items as we work through the demo. On the left-hand side here, you will see that there are several things that we can use to filter down our selection criteria to get to the final product that we want to be able to select and customize. These areas are basically item attributes that are assigned to the particular items. In SCA, they're called facets, but again, they're used to filter down the items that we have loaded and available to select from based on different criteria. We've got attributes of felt color, finish color, table size, on special. You can build as many of these as you want to allow your customer or yourself as you're building a quote to select down and narrow down the item that you're trying to get to. So for this particular example, we're going to go ahead and say, let's see everything that has the attribute of felt color of green. So we're going to click on green. And when we do, you'll notice that we now are left with two of our items. We had the dartboard disappear because dartboards obviously don't have felt, so they wouldn't have a felt color of green. But we do see that the Artero pool table and the Tremont pool table would both be options that would come with the ability to customize and have green felt. So let's go ahead and clear the filter that we use. We'll go back to all of our product. And because I know that with the Tremont, there are different aspects of the Tremont table that we can customize, I'm going to go ahead and select that one. So when I click on that, that brings us to the item specific area of our shopping site. Here we have the item details for the Tremont. Based on the way that this has been constructed within SCA, we have the ability to see things like review ratings. This would have ratings, comments, things about the Tremont table that we'd be able to read. If this was, again, more of an external facing website, the customer would have the ability to see that detail. But because this is being demonstrated as an in-store selling application, we're not going to be too concerned about that right now. You'll see that we have the various aspects of what we can select to build our customized table. These are the different attributes that we can add or assign. You'll see that with the Tremont, when we first select that item, there is a range of price for this particular table. This table can range anywhere from $1,999.99 to $2,398.99. And this is all dependent upon how we customize our final product that we want to see. You'll notice that at the bottom of this particular page, we have several different options. Once we're done constructing this particular customized item, we can add it to our shopping cart, we can add it to a wish list, or we can add it to a quote. And for this particular demo, we are going to show what it looks like to add this to a quote, because this would symbolize us sitting down with a customer in store, building out the product, so let's saving it as a quote and having that go to the back-end ERP for later functionality, approvals, review, whatever would need to be done with that quote, and stored within the system for later use that we can pull up for this particular customer. So let's go ahead and build out our product. So we are going to start by selecting our pocket style. In this particular case, the only pocket style that's available within the Tremont is the exposed pockets. We're going to select our 8-foot table since this is the only option that that comes in. Our next option is to select the felt color, and we can see in this particular case what the tan table looks like. But let's say that we want to show our customer what it would look like in green. So we can go ahead and click on that, and you'll notice that the picture does dynamically change to show what the green table would look like with this particular construction. This can be controlled by having various images for the different components that we're building. You can either layer components and have them build together, which is a little bit more complicated and would take a little bit more web design prowess, but it can be done. Or you can have images that reflect each of the different combinations so that those that change dynamically would be displayed based on the selection criteria. The next option is to select the leg type, so ball and claw. The next option is the finish color. So we've got a couple different here. We've got chestnut and we have espresso. The one that we're currently displaying is the chestnut color. So that's what would be indicated if I click on that. But let's say that the customer wants to see what it looks like in espresso. So now we click on that and we see that it's a little bit darker, which in this particular case, the customer likes. So that's the option that we're going to go with. We're going to select our manufacturer. And then you can see that currently the price still hasn't been finalized based on what we've selected so far. But we still have one option left to select, and that's going to be the felt type. So in this particular case, based on our matrix items that we have behind the scenes in the ERP, we know that there are some different prices associated with the felt type. So the standard felt type would have a different price than the stain resistant felt type. So to demonstrate that, we'll go ahead and click on the standard felt type. So now we've constructed our table the way that we want it, and we're saying that we want to look and see if the price is with the standard felt. And in this particular case, that price would be $1,999.99. But as we continue to discuss it with the customer, we think that it might be wise to go and look at the pricing for the stain resistant felt type. So let's go ahead and change our selection criteria to stain resistant. And you'll notice that when we select that, the price does in fact change to $2,250. This is indicative of adding the stain resistant felt type to the various components that we've used to customize our table. So this does show that we have the ability to change prices based on the different criteria used to build our final product. Now that we have selected all the options that we want to customize our table with, we have those various options that I mentioned to you earlier. We can add it to the cart, we can add it to the wish list, or we can add it to a quote. In this particular example, I am going to go ahead and I'm going to add this to a quote so we can see what that looks like on the back end in the ERP system. So I clicked on add to quote, and then I'm going to go ahead and look at my quote request to make sure that everything that I want quoted is included. I do have the ability to add many things to the quote before I submit it. So when I clicked on that button, that brought us to the request a quote screen. And I'm just going to scroll down here, and you can see that there is text on here that's customizable, that you can change the verbiage to say whatever you wanted to. If this is something that you're being used either for the internal or external website, you can make that either instructional information for the sales associate, or it could be information directly for the client if this happened to be an external facing website. You can see everything that's going to be included in the quote when we submit it. In this particular case, this is going to be the Tremont table that we customized. You can see all the details of the selection criteria that we used. You can see our customer here and the shipping information. So this is what the quote screen, what the quote screen would look like right out of the box. And this is all customizable through SCA. So now that we know that we want to submit the quote for the Tremont table, we're going to go ahead and click submit the quote request. You can see now that it's processing. So it has in fact sent that information over to the NetSuite ERP, and it has now become an estimate within the ERP system. Again, this just is confirmation that that quote has been submitted. All of this text is customizable and can be changed to reflect what you want it to, whether this be an internal selling application or an external website. So now let's go ahead and see what happened back in the ERP. So I'm going to go ahead and click back here. I'm going to navigate out to see our estimates. I'm going to click on that. Go ahead and list out our estimates. Now, if we look for the latest estimate that was created, you will see that we do in fact have our estimate created within the ERP for our user Jack Frost for our price of $2,250. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at that estimate. Here you will see the details of that particular estimate. Here's our customer, here's the date that it was that estimate was created. Here is the particular item that makes up that estimate. Again, if we had added more things to the quote request back on our in-store selling application, we would see that reflected here under the item section with all the items that are part of this particular quote. From within the system now here in the ERP, you have different things that you can do. You can build in approval workflow if this needs to be reviewed or anything needs to be done to communicate with the manufacturer to see if any details need to be included. You can actually complete the process in the back-end system here. You can create the sales order, cash sale. You can invoice it. So you can take all of your sale functionality that you would normally do in terms of converting an estimate to a sale within the ERP. Or just for demonstration purposes, we will go back to our website and see that this is now an available quote. It's captured back in the ERP system. And we can go to our quote. It's going to be the latest one that we've just created. We're going to open that up. And here's our quote. And now that you can see that from the in-store selling application, so if our sales associate pulled this back up in SCA, they would be able to pull this quote up and they would be able to review this with the customer. They'd be able to place the order. They can also download this and give it as a takeaway for the customer to take home and talk over with their spouse if they wanted to, or whatever the reason would be to walk away with the quote. That quote is now stored with that customer and is available for later use for conversion into an actual sale. So as you can see, a lot of functionality gives us the ability to take some items, to change, configure that particular item with the customizations that we want to. We can have the price reflect the final product that we built. We can see that now goes over to the ERP and gets stored as a quote or as an estimate. That estimate can be worked through the sale process either back in the ERP system within NetSuite, or it can be managed here through the front end that we developed as part of our in-store selling application. So there are details that we can show just in conclusion here of how this kind of operates in the back-end system. So as we navigated back, we did see the estimate, and these are all the various things that we can do from the estimate perspective within the ERP. And just to show you a little bit of context around how this was organized, I'm going to go ahead and show you that if we go to lists, accounting, and go to items, and I'm just going to show what this looks like on the items perspective. And this was the, what was the name of our product again? Our product was called the Tremont. So this is the parent item, and the way that this was displayed on the in-store selling application was the various combinations of attributes that make up the item. So we start with a parent item, in this case it's the Tremont, and then we build matrix items off of that, which indicate the various combinations of attributes that can be used to come up with what that final product could potentially look like. So in this case, we will look at our Tremont item, which this is the parent, and there's all kinds of details that are specific to setting up an item in the ERP. But what I really wanted to highlight here is that if we go over to the accounting tab, you'll see that these are the different attributes that we assigned to the parent item that gives us the ability to come up with matrix items, which are all the combinations that we can build that product to. So here you will see all those things that we were able to select back in the in-store selling application. and the various options that are underneath there. And then based on those options that we've defined for the parent item, we build all of our matrixed items. And here you can see a list of, based on the options that I have assigned to the parent, the different matrixed item combinations that can be created. So this is just to give you an indication of what this looks like from the backend perspective, that you create a parent item. And then from that parent item, you select all the different facets or attributes that you want to have available to customize that particular item. And you build matrixed items off of that with all the various combinations. And each of those various combinations can have different price structures, different pricing rules that were indicated by making that, in our case, making that selection for the felt style or the felt type, whether it be standard or stain resistant. We had price breaks assigned to that particular attribute, which we saw reflected when we selected that in the in-store selling application. So just a little bit of detail about how this all comes together. Again, it's a nice feature that gives us the ability to take items, customize items, and see final pricing based on that combination of items, attributes that we did select. So this will complete the demo, and I hope it was informative.